It is a pleasure to introduce the talk by Francesca Marcon from Politecnico di Torino. And she's going to talk about lowest order stabilization free virtual element method. So we look forward then to hear why the stabilization can be avoided, Francesca. So the floor is yours, please.
Thank you, Marco. And I want to thank you, the organizer, for the invitation. Today I present my work that is about a lowest order stabilization free virtual element method. This is a joint work with my supervisor, Professor Stefano Berrone and Andrea Borio. The outline of my talk is as follows. First, I will present the method applied to the discrete formulation of the Poisson problem, the 2D Poisson problem. Then I will give a sketch of the proof of well-posedness. Finally, I will present some numerical results about the convergence of the method. And then I will give a brief idea of my current work about the higher order method. You can find the details of this talk in the preprint that I write here at the end of this slide. Then we analyze the Poisson problem with the homogeneous Dirichlet boundary condition. In order to state the discrete formulation of the problem, we have to define a polygonal tessellation of our domain omega that has to satisfy the standard virtual elements assumptions. Then I want to give the definition of the local discrete space that we call enlarged enhancement virtual element space of order one. And as you see, this is the local space for any given star-shaped polygon E. We define a parameter L that is a natural number. And in this, we enlarged the polynomial space, and you see that this space is similar to the one, the standard virtual element one. However, we enlarged the polynomial space in order to compute some higher order projector. So we see that the functions are H1 functions whose Laplacian is on this polynomial enlarged space of order L plus 1. On the boundary, these are the standard VEM virtual element functions, and then they have to satisfy this enlarged enhancement property. And here we denoted, standard denoted by pi nabla, the H1 orthogonal projector, and that is defined uniquely choosing a linear and continuous operator on constants, which is classically denoted by P0. Notice that we can choose as the degrees of freedom of the space, the values of the functions at the vertices of the polygon E, that is the same choice that we can done in the standard virtual element method. Then, in order to give the discrete formulation, we also have to give the definition of the main character of the bilinear form, which is the projector pi zero L, which is the projector on the space of gradients of E2 VEM functions to the enlarged vector space of polynomials of order L. It is defined by the standard orthogonality condition, and notice that for each VEM function, it is computable given the degrees of freedom of U exploiting the previously seen enlarged enhancement property. Let us focus now on the discrete problem where we see that we can choose, or now we choose for each polygon a value of this parameter L, and we define this discrete problem Notice that we didn't not add the stabilization term that is classical on the VEM formulation. Then we prove the well-posedness of this formulation. This theorem is the main result of our work. This theorem states that locally on each polygon, let L be a natural number that has to satisfy the sufficient condition, that is the first one here, that has that L plus 1 times L plus 2 has to be greater or equal than the number of vertices of the polygon minus 1, then the operator pi 0L is injective on the space of gradients of functions. This result induces the existence of an equivalent norm on the global virtual space with respect to the standard H1 norm. And this implies directly that the bilinear form of the discrete problem is continuous and coercive. So we can say that it satisfies the hypothesis of Lotz-Milgram theorem and it is well-posedness. Now, briefly, I want to give you the sketch of the proof of this theorem. It is done in two steps. The first one is to prove that the thesis can that there is, sorry, a sufficient condition for the thesis that is an auxiliary in subcondition. And then the second step is obviously the proof of this in subcondition. So first, we prove that the hypothesis that pi 0 L on the gradient of U is equal to 0 implies that the pi nabla of U is a constant. Then it is equal to P0 of U. Then by exploiting the definition of this projector, pi 0 L, we obtain this second relation. This relation restricts the problem on the boundary of the polygon. However, we come back on the polygon E through the lifting of the VEM functions on the space RQE. That is the space of piecewise linear continuous polynomials defined on a subtriangulation of the polygon that we denoted by TE. This subtriangulation can be obtained linking each vertex of the polygon with the center of it. Then we are now on the polygon, and the previous relation is equivalent to the one that I write here, that can be also denoted, and it is we prove that this is a bilinear continuous form. And now we can state that this relation implies that Q is equal to zero, Q bar, if an if subcondition, that is a standard if subcondition on this bilinear form B, holds. We know that it is directly known that if bar Q is equal to zero, we say that U is constant on the polygon, and then we have the thesis because of the definition of the VEM space. So we have to prove this in subcondition. In order to do that, we have to define first a space that we call V, that is the space of H1 piecewise function on the triangulation TE. These functions, the jump of these functions have to be bounded, the jumps on the internal edges of the triangulation. Then we prove the IMSU condition by defining a Fortin operator. A Fortin operator standard called pi e, that is a linear continuous operator from the vector space V to the vector space of the enlarged polynomials. And this operator pe is defined through the definition of P2, other two operators, P2 and P1. we define P1 as the integral mean of a function on the space V, and P2 is defined in order to satisfy this property that is, in a certain sense, a B in the sense of the bilinear form defined previously, orthogonality condition. We prove that this second operator exists if the first hypothesis, the hypothesis on the choice of L, is true. This is the end of the sketch of this proof, but I want to underline the linking between this hypothesis and the dimension of the space involved in this relation. Then we derived the a priori error estimates in H1 norm and in L2 norm, which are the standard one that we expected. And we prove numerically these a priori error estimates. First, before giving these results, I want to focus on the choice of L that has to be done for each polygon in order to satisfy the sufficient condition that we have just seen. And here I present a table where we see that, as expected, L behaves as the square root of the number of vertices, and this said that L increases slowly with respect to the number of vertices of the polygon. We use these four types of meshes for the convergence test. Here I want to focus on the types of polygons, yes, that are presented in these four meshes, in order to link these values with the choice that we have to make of the parameter L in the different polygons. Finally, these are the convergence results that we obtain. We denoted the convergence rates by alpha, and we approximately obtain two for the L2 error and one for the H1 error, which are the results that we expect. And here I wanted also to write the way in which we approximate and compute the L2 error and the H1 error. Then finally, I want to present briefly my current work about the E2 VAM space of order K, where K is greater than one. We see that, as before, we have to change the space in order to enable the computation of higher order projector. In this case, we compute the projection of order k plus l minus 1 in order to have the Wolposness of the problem. And so we change the local VAM space in order to make this computable. Finally, here I present the convergence results that we obtain, for instance, for order k equal to 2, where we obtain order convergence rates of 3 for the L2 error and of 2 for H1 error. And I want to underline the sufficient condition on L that we use and we prove numerically in this case, that is the one that I write at the top of this slide, that is that L plus 1 times L plus 2 has to be greater or equal than K times the number of vertices of the polygon minus 1. And with these results, I finish my talk, and thank you all for the attention.